That's awesome, Droy.
Hi, R2. Yeah, no, you're good. Look at this.
They're all good.
Yeah, yeah.
The full spin. The full spin.
Oh, wow. Hey, we are back at Disneyland today because I was feeling, let's just have a Star Wars activity day. So let's go around the whole park, just do some Star Wars stuff. Come explore with me. What better way to kick off the day than to ride Star Tours, which has a new Rise of Skywalker expansion thing to it, and I have not ridden that yet. So let's see. Let's see what's up. Star Tours. Always a nice day on Star Tours. I haven't actually been on this ride since they added the Rise of Skywalker edition, so I'm kind of excited to see it. I loved that movie. I know a lot of people hate it, but I'm really excited for whatever edition is set up on this ride.
Star Tours, you'll never miss a thing.
C-3PO's just chilling. I've never seen this video.
Say it all, the comfort and convenience of your Star's Peter City. Sensation. It's the scenic way to see the galaxy, and it's only on Star Tours.
Yeah.
Woo!
Hey, hot take.
Attention, please.
I actually prefer Star Tours to Millennium Falcon Smuggler's Run. Smuggler's Run is awesome, but Star Tours is a more fun thrill ride than Smuggler's Run. DJ Rex, there he is. I always thought they should remove DJ Rex once he became the Cantina DJ, because like, what's he doing in the line for Star Tours as well as at the Cantina? Want me to believe full immersion, Disney? Make it happen. Row 3. There we go.
R2-D2, what's going on here? We are not ready for takeoff. R2, don't you dare make the drop to light speed.
Whoa.
We just passed the end on moon. Whoa, look out!
Whoa!
R2, to fix those engines immediately. You know I can't swim. And neither can you.
Oh my god.
Whoa! Go away, beastly thing! Go out, man!
Oh no!
R2, save us!
Oh man!
A transmission?
I am Lando Calrissian with the Resistance.
General Calrissian. Nice to see a familiar face.
Well, it's good to see you, too. And you, too, R2. Listen, the First Order is rallying its forces. We need your help. Rendezvous with the coordinates I'm transmitting. Good luck.
R2, I really don't think we should rush into the...
Oh!
This is suicide! We'll be smashed to pieces. In the event we don't make it, I want you to know that you have been the most wonderful passengers.
Oh, no!
Pull up, Arthur! Pull up!
All pilots, this is it.
You're right, Arthur. This mission cannot fail. Activate the laser cannons.
Yeah!
That's a great item. You've got two ties on your tail.
They're on me, guys. I can't
shake
them.
Get
up. R2, the odds of successfully taking out two TIE fighters at once is
better
than I thought. Well done.
All right, squad. Start the attack.
Oh, no!
Remember, aim for the cannon.
What are you waiting for? Fire!
Nice.
Thanks for your help, Star Tours.
It has been an honor.
Oh! Whoa.
I hope you have enjoyed your flight.
Oh, no! Oh, yeah!
That's my ship. We've got a lot of explaining.
On behalf of Starfleet, thank you for joining us.
That was amazing.
Thank you for flying Star Tours. Bye-bye.
That was awesome. Again, if you're a big fan of Rise of Skywalker, I love that you could see the Emperor's lightning shoot up at one point. I kind of wish they would have continued that all the way through, because then like you maybe could have had your ship fall from the sky. Oh, also, spoiler alerts for Rise of Skywalker. but, man, so good. Just in case you're wondering, they do Savi's building lightsabers, but they also have a cheaper version that you can do in docking bay. More simple setup. It's actually nice for kids because, let's be honest, you're not going to spend $200 on all of your kids. Maybe, but that's a lot of money. You know what? Let's just bite the bullet and go back to Galaxy's Edge. See what's going on back there. Maybe grab some snacks. They got some new snacks. That Rise of the Resistance is open. We can see how crazy it is over by Rise of the Resistance, and maybe do single rider for Falcon. It's a Star Wars day. It really is nothing like entering from the middle entrance. I like all the woodland around it. So for the first time in forever, look at this. The milk stand has a line. And you know why that is? Because they have a new item. It's called this Green Milk Toydarian Swirl. It's supposed to be like a spicy green milk concoction. Anyway, that's what we're gonna try. Oh, perfect. Oh,
look at that. Have a good journey.
Thank you. Have a good journey. Where are we going? So here's the Toydarian Swirl. Looks nice, looks good. The only issue with it is, can you see? Looks a little gross on top. It has some type of pepper. And then mango chunks. And I don't actually know what else is in it. That is weird. Who thought? Like someone at Disney was like, oh, you know what will make the green milk better? More people will get it? If you put some spiciness in it. All right, so there's mango chunks in it. That's good. It is like good. So it's like, the spice isn't hot. So if you're looking for something spicy, it's not that. It's more of like very savory. This is now a savory drink instead of overly sweet. It weirdly goes well, the mango and the whatever's on top. I gotta figure out, let's put it in the lower third, whatever spice is on top here. But it's like way better than what the green milk was. Look at that. The milk stand is booming now. So I guess moral of the story is if you make something spicy, people will turn up. Let's keep walking. This is the new droids. Interact with each other. Right? This guy's going crazy. This guy's not doing much. Oh no, he's shaking. You want some of this drink? Anyway, here's to you, new Coke droid. I mean, other people are going to battle and going to war, but you've got your job and you do it well. Don't let anybody tell you otherwise. You know what, I sort of felt like over time this would get less good. Like you kind of be like, I'm over this, but it's actually getting better. Again, you wouldn't like get a lot of these, but in terms of like a savory drink, it's like weirdly good. There she is. Should we do Smuggler's Run? We do Single Rider. What do we have to lose? Let's go do it. Let's go pilot or engineer the Millennium Falcon, more likely. All right, let's do it to it. Let's Falcon it up, Single Rider. Single Rider is great on this ride. The only issue is you don't see the Hondo and Aka animatronic. You skip right through that room. Otherwise, totally worth it though. Cuts down time drastically, especially if you're by yourself. Oh, I'm a gunner. I always go over and like want to push this button. Nothing ever happens. Sometimes if you push it, an alarm will go off. But I think someone needs to be paying attention to you. Work. Let's look for a porg's nest. Oh, there it is. The porg's nest right up there. See it? It's in the back wall above whatever this pipe is. I love how when we came here on opening day, this place was just like amazing. This is a great example of how you take for granted what you have too readily available to you. Because look at this. Now it's like everyone's like, eh, we're just waiting. Just waiting to get on the other ride in Galaxy's Edge. Oh, that's us.
In the front, gunners in the middle.
Oh, someone pushed the button. And it worked. That's all I wanted. It's been a second since I've been on this. Oh my god. Oh man, the train.
Yes.
Oh no. Oh. We're in trouble now. Oh no. Oh no. Oh my god. I got it. That's the best part. This is the best part of the record. It's really cool.
This would greatly help the resistance.
Oh my god.
You have heard the first
order. We did it.
Made Chewie proud.
We did it. That's fun. It's a nice thing. I prefer to be engineer and just sort of like sit back and not do anything. I mean, like, I know it's not a good thing, but it's more fun to ride the ride than it is to actually like participate. That's not a good thing about that ride, but that's the reality of it. Wow, I haven't seen this in a while. There's a line to get into docking base or into Dock Ondor's Den of Antiquities. That's interesting, isn't it? Rise of the Resistance is open now. I wonder if that is what made the difference. Now all of a sudden this land is back at like its opening day style capacity. Anyway, everywhere back here is pretty busy. I think everyone's just waiting for their boarding groups to be called. Let's go take a look to see how Rise of the Resistance is doing. Look at this. It finally is what they envisioned. It's packed over here now. Chewie and Vi Marati are out here. Normally, the groups make it so that people don't need to wait around. You can kind of go enjoy other spaces around Disneyland. And then when your group is called, you have 2 hours to get over here and get on this ride. It's an amazing way to do it, and it's way more fair. It's a much more fair system to do this. However, as we learned, there's no guarantee you're getting onto a ride in a particular day.
Hello, darkness, my old.
So if you're not an annual pass holder, it really is devastating. So I'm sorry to you those who didn't get on in their first visit. I mean, good luck in your second one. Fingers crossed. I'm like really hoping for you. And oh, I haven't seen this yet. It's R2-D2. I saw videos of this online and I was like, eh, it looks kind of like sort of okay, but in person it's a lot more impressive. I mean, like, this is what Galaxy's Edge needs, is more of this stuff. Oh, that's awesome droid. R2-D2. Just chilling. Hi, R2. Yeah. No, you're good. Look at this.
They're all good.
Yeah. Look, full spin. The full spin. Oh wow. This is a glamour shot. All right, bye, R2. Awesome. I'm gonna replay that footage with some top model style music behind it, some lens flares to really spice it up. Let's see how good we can make R2 look. All joking aside, that's an awesome interaction that they have. Like, I mean, Rey is great. Vi Marati is my favorite because she really plays into the whole land story. Kylo Ren's great, Stormtroopers are great. They're really getting close to what they pitched when they first like introduced this land. It's starting to really be executed. Now that Rise of Resistance is finished, I mean, it's complete. Galaxy's Edge is exactly what they pitched to us. The only thing that's missing is the datapad interactivity. It'd be nice if when you crash the Falcon or something like that, it does show up like somebody at Oga's goes, there's a bounty on your head. But still, so cool. As we continue our Star Wars tour of Disneyland, we can start wandering over here to maybe Launch Bay. Well, we're probably getting close to the end of Launch Bay being open. It was only ever supposed to be a temporary character meet and greet, but oh, whoa, Boba Fett's out. Let's go meet Boba Fett. Hi, Mr. Fett. How are you doing?
Why? Don't I look happy?
You always look happy. Did you hear about this new dude in The Mandalorian? No?
Stand aside.
Oh, no. That was a weird interaction with Boba Fett. He was having none of it. Also, not a fan of The Mandalorian. Did you know that Boba Fett's not a Mandalorian? And if you notice, there's a giant dent in his helmet, which if you've watched The Mandalorian, you know that Beskar armor can't get dents. It's blaster proof. So, rip off armor? Maybe. That's the theory. Well, I gotta be honest, the Boba Fett interaction left a sour taste in my mouth, but that is how we're going to end Star Wars Day. So thanks for casually walking around, just enjoying the different Star Wars stuff here at Galaxy's Edge and just Disneyland in general. The new Star Tours is probably the highlight for me. And then, yeah, we'll see how it rises. Yes, maybe, sometimes. let's call it a day. So thanks for exploring with me today. Thanks for enjoying Star Wars. Hopefully you thought the new Star Tours was awesome. I know I did. If you're a big fan of Rise of Skywalker, I know you did. Thanks for watching, and until next time, we'll see you in the happy place.